What's up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Tesla Canadian Dad. Today we're going to talk about... Seriously, buddy? Again?
Hey, what's up, buddy?
I'll do it. Okay? Don't forget to hit that like button. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. We really appreciate it. So, again, are you satisfied now? Yeah? Well, you know, I just want to know more about this car. I want to know, like, what happens if you actually, run out of gas or power. That's better. I guess today's episode is about questions, right? What does this car really have to offer? What do you guys need to know about this car? So I guess
we'll put 300 seconds on the clock
and we'll get started now.
Number one is autopilot. Autopilot will use 8 cameras that is facing outside of the car. It will accelerate and stop for you depending on the traffic around you. The second part of autopilot is Autosteer, which means it's going to keep your car in the lane. Number two is a big one, full self-driving. Now this means that the car will actually get on the highway and off the highway all by itself. There is no human interaction needed. As of today, full self-driving is only available on highways. That means it's going to take the on-ramp and the off-ramp and everything in between completely by itself. It will even change from one highway to next without user input. Number three is summon, regular summon, where the car will go forward and backwards depending if you're hitting the reverse or advance inside the application on your phone. The car will slowly back up or slowly creep forward for you to get out of tight spots. On smart summon, your car will navigate more complex environments and parking spaces, maneuvering around objects to come find you in a parking lot. Number four, auto park. Another part of full self-driving is auto park. The car will actually park itself. This is nothing new. Other cars do this, but it's a nice addition to the car if you have a hard time getting into spots. Number five, full self-driving in 2020. This means the car will actually drive by itself throughout the city. It will recognize red lights, stop signs, do turns for you. So that is something to look forward to in 2020. This car is mind-boggling when it comes to acceleration. From the slowest to the fastest, the Tesla Model 3 will do 5.6 seconds up to 3.2 seconds depending on the model you have. When it comes to ordering the Model 3, there's 3 different versions. The standard range plus, the long range, and the performance model. Easy entry means that the car will actually adjust the seats, the steering wheel, as well as all the different customizations that you've done to the car when it comes to the self-driving options. You can control everything with your phone. Turn on the heat, turn on the fog, tilt down the windows, start charging your car, lock your doors, open the frunk, open the trunk. Easter eggs, there is a ton of them, from the cowbell to the farts, you name it. It is filled with different Easter eggs to find and explore in this car. Number 11 is electrical versus gasoline. Now, don't hate me for this, but it is a fact that it is significantly cheaper to power a car versus gas up your car. Now, on average, again, depending on the location you are, you're looking at a 20 to 30% cost versus gasoline cars. That's a 70 to 80% cost saving for owning an electric car. SENTRY mode records everything that's going around your car when you're not close to it. Meaning, if somebody keys your car, you'll know about it. The supercharging network. There is thousands upon thousands of now supercharging networks everywhere around us to be able to go from one location to the next and be able to go on road trips with these electric cars. There is superchargers everywhere now. Hey, there's even a supercharger in Woodstock, New Brunswick. The Tesla Model 3 standard range and long range both have hubcaps that come with it. You are allowed to remove that hubcap. It will reduce your range, however. Number 15, storage, and more storage. You can store things in the trunk, you can store things in the frunk, and if that's not enough, you can store things in the bottom of the trunk as well. There is no spare wheel in this car, and they use that area where typically a spare wheel would be located as more storage. Auto headlights will turn on and off depending, of course, on upcoming traffic and traffic in front of you. Games, games, and more games. There is a plenty of games in this Tesla Model 3 to keep you busy when doing supercharging, for example. Browsers are now available in all Tesla Model 3s as well. You can even stream videos in the browser when the car is stopped. Number 19, can you drive while sleeping? No, it is still not legal to sleep in your car, so pay attention. Your Tesla will ask you to nudge it every 30 to 90 seconds to make sure you're still paying attention. You can stream Netflix while the car is stopped. YouTube is the same, streaming available on LTE or Wi-Fi when the car is fully stopped. Hulu is also available in the United States. Spotify is now available to all Tesla Model 3s. Stream as much music as you want. So that's it for this episode. Hopefully you know a little bit more about the Tesla Model 3. Don't forget to hit that like button. Don't forget to smash that subscribe button if that's something you're into. And if you end up buying a Tesla Model 3, please use my referral code. I would greatly appreciate it. You get free supercharging. I get free supercharging. Everybody wins. And yeah, we are going to catch you in the next episode.
Finally.
What?
Yeah, I've been waiting for like...
Let's go.
Guys, I put a lot of work into this video. Honestly, the first 90 seconds took a long time to put together. So if you're still watching this at this point in time, just hit that subscribe button. You know, you've made it to the end. You know, you've obviously haven't gotten bored and, you know, maybe hopefully a little bit entertained. And that's what I'm here for. I just love making videos, honestly. It's a big passion of mine and something I've been getting back into. And obviously I'd appreciate any support. So if you wanna share that video online with us, obviously it's going to really, really help us out. Tim Horton has the reputation of having the best coffee here in Canada, but I beg to differ. McDonald's is actually way better.